Okay, so I believe that we can start right now. First of all, thank you for coming. I'm Mihael, and I'll be talking about some Android animations, and I'll throw some RxJava in it to make it reactive. So first of all, I'm here from Five, from Croatian, the design-driven app development agency. You can check it out. And have you ever used RxJava in production? Yeah, so how many of you used maybe RxJava with animations? Oh, we have a few hands. Nice. So before we start, this is not an RxJava course. We're not talking about RxJava in general or the RxJava API. We'll be just consuming some interfaces and wrap our value animators and view property animators in some reactive way. And we'll be not talking about transition framework or the object animator. And this talk will be kind of like the journey to the RxZation of the animations framework. And first of all, I'll present the problem. It's something like this. If you're fortunate or unfortunate, you have a designer by your side, and they, just a second, they tend to give you some nice animations like this. It looks real nice at first. But I can even just speed it down a little bit, like this, to better see what is going on. We have some fade in, some views are translating, fading in, there are some delay between views, we have some view rotating, etc. And okay, at first when we look at it, what we see is that we have some dynamic text, just a second, right here. We have some view pager. We have to fetch the data from the view pager. What is actually going on behind the scenes is, oh, just a second. Okay, so I'll just skip this a little bit. This is going on. So we create the view. Oh my God, sorry. We create the view, and we pass the view and data to our presenter. And that presenter starts to fetch the data for us. There's some usernames, some colors, and when it fetches the data, it returns to the view. Like the username, get colors, it maps the colors to some view model, pass the view model to the view. And when presenter doesn't have to know anything about the view, this is like this, we want to keep our presenters non-Android. And they only care about data, they give data to the view, and they say, okay, start animation. And view has to handle that, how to animate. And after all, we want to have a nice looking code. And with this, right here we see, okay, presenter got the data, give the data to the view, and he says, like, okay, now animate. And what's going on the view side? When the view gets the data, it has to update some view pager, it has to do some additional stuff. It cannot just start the animation when the presenter wants it. And this is, like, the problem here. So how do we manage that? Okay, my clicker died. So let's do this. Initially, we would do some layout animations for view groups, maybe view property animation for the views. And at first, it looks OK. It would probably work. And it looks something like this. We have to pre-transform our views. We have to create view property animators. And we have to wire them up together. And this is all happening in the view. And for me, this is actually really bad, because you has to do a lot of stuff. There's animators know about other animators. And when you have like 10 views like we have, this is like a real deal, and it has a lot of code right there. So let's better not do this. And we would also have to synchronize all that data that's coming. We have the animation callback hell. And where is that the cancellation of animation? Everything is asynchronous. And you have to notify some presenter when the animation is over, if our presenter cares about it. So it's not real nice looking code. There has to be a better way, and we can do it a better way. So it's something, everything is asynchronous. Maybe reactive paradigm can help here, and RxJava. It helps with synchronization. And what our presenter really cares about the animation to start it, to be notified when the animation is over, and that it can cancel animation if it wants. So yeah. Double slide. So actually, it sounds really like a completable, if we really think about it. And let's see if we can wrap that layout animations and viewport animations in the completable. And actually, we can. We have that little nice completable create from completable unsubscribe interface. And if we take a look at it, it just has to our class has to implement that call method, which is called once we subscribe to that. And it's really simple. We call unsubscribe, we give it a subscription, and that subscription is called when we unsubscribe, which is great for the cancellation of the animation and some clearing up the resources. And if there's an error, we just call an error, and when it's completed, we call uncomplete on the completable subscriber. And how our class looks like, this animated first version of our class, we can just wrap the property animator. We give that property animator to our class, and when we subscribe to it, we just call the property animator start, and here we chain up that end action when we call uncompleted. And what did we get with this? This is how our view looks like now. We still have to pre-transform, and we still have to create the animators, but the chaining looks nicer, because now property animators does know about other property animators, and we can easily swap them out and chain them up as we like them. And can we remove that animation creation from the view itself? So that view just gives us that view that it wants to animate, and that's it. And let's try it out. First, we can change our class to something like this. We would give some reference to the view. And when we subscribe to that animation, we check if the view is still there. If it's not, we just complete, okay? We cannot do anything. But if it's there, we create animator. We set up our animation, and we start animation as well with this uncomplete listener. And what did we get with that? This, now our view just now cares about wiring it up and which animation to run on which view. Where are the transformations? We did not see transformations here, but they are not in the activity or fragment, because in this class we can actually add pre-transformation right here, because we know which animation we are doing. We can pre-transform that view. Like if we are fading in the view, we want to make it invisible first and then fade it in. What other concept is, we have that animate fade in on subscribe method class, and we would have to create that additional class for every transformation or animation that we want. And this is kind of like the explosion of classes, especially if we want to do many different animations. But the view is not creating animations directly, which is nice, and doesn't have to print transform any views, which is okay if you just care about what animation it does on which view. But are we really satisfied? I mean, this could work, this works, but there's probably a better way. We don't want that many classes right here. We have to go better. The idea here is to make a builder. The view property animator is builder by itself, and we can just wrap it around another reactive builder. And what we really want is to give that view, we give our view that want to animate to that builder, which we call just animated it. We want to transform and pre-transform that view. We want to pre-transform and animate that view. And when we call schedule, we get the completable, and we can subscribe to the completable and run that animation. So how would that builder look like? Something like this. We give them the view. We can define duration, delay before the animation starts, and some interpolator. And we'll just have a view property animator in the background. And that's it. The creation is here. And this is the interesting part. So our Rx animation builder has a view. That view has a view property animator. And when we call some methods on that builder, like fade in, we want to create pre-transform actions and animate actions. Those pre-transform actions will be called before the animation, like hide it or, I don't know, move it somewhere around. For this example, for fade in, we want to hide it. And then when we want to animate, we just fade in that view. Another example is when we want to move that view from one point to the other. We want to firstly move it somewhere back, for example, and then move it into that place. And it looks something like this. So our builder has a list, about that two lists right here, where it stores the transformations. One are the pre-transformation actions, that we will call the pre-transformation interview, and animate actions. And this is just like example of the fade-in method. We add like alpha to transparent, and we animate to a POG and return our builder. This is another example when we translate it by some X and Y. We firstly pre-transform it here and then transform it back with some animation. And that's the tricky part. Our schedule part is just, again, completable on subscribe. But this time, we are receiving a view reference and both lists of pre-transform actions and animation actions. And as you see here, those pre-transform actions can be actually nullable. So we can just give them the animation actions, and we would animate the view from, I don't know, from left to right, and we would not animate it, pre-animate it. So it actually goes to the place where we animated to, and not back to the place where it is. And when we call it, again, we just check if the view is null, everything is the same. And the little tricky part is here that actually, view property animators are singletons for the view itself. So we have to apply actions for pre-transform and set duration to zero, start delay to zero, because if we animated that view before with some another duration, that duration stays for that animator. We just recycle that view property animator in the background. And with end action, we run our animation. That animation is run like here. We just apply our animation actions. And when we're completed, we just go on completed. And that's it. This is how it looks like. When we schedule, we just create a completable from the class and give it the view and the actions. And that's it, basically. But we're almost there. We could use that builder as it is. But if we have some, if we have, for example, many same animations, we could wrap it up in some class that helps us with that, like hide view. We can some helper methods like fade in, like enter, that handles that builder for us, and we just give them some properties like we give view, okay, enter with this offset, and it fades in, rolls in, like we saw in the video. If we even have, this is the good part, because we can now utilize the RxJava API. We can enter multiple views with deletion, with some delay, like this. We just iterate over the views, and we apply that builder to each view. And this is how our activity fragment looks like. When we start animation, we just say, okay, animate this together, fade in that view, slide in that view, and this will be together. Okay, then after this is done, cock it with enter views with delay, and I don't know, some two, three views. And when this is done, rotate another view. And I think that this looks amazing. It's just nice, it's readable, and it's really awesome. And this is how our view looks like when we add other stuff. This looks a bit scary, but this is the explanation. We have all that delays and durations in one place, and we can orchestrate our animation from this, and everything is one place, and we know what we're doing. And our presenter looks like this. It says, okay, set up initial animation, conquer with start initial animation, and subscribe. And it doesn't care when that animation will happen, and if view has to do anything special, it will just wait to end, and it will get notified, and it can unsubscribe and stop that animation. Yeah, and how it can stop that animation? The completable subscriber has that unsubscribe method where we pass our subscription. And that subscription is called when the animation is over, and we unsubscribe them automatically, or we unsubscribe ourselves. And look at our helper class, clear subscription, that takes action, and that action is called when we unsubscribe. And it looks something like this. We just add it here in our animate unsubscribe, and we do some actions that we need to clear resources. This is not important actually here, because view property animator is under the view, and if view gets destroyed, view property gets destroyed as well, and it's not that big of a deal. But this is actually a problem with value animators. And we were talking about that view throttle where view has to do something. So this is this part here. How can we fix that? Well, we could use behavior subject like a signal. And we just chain it up and say, okay, when this completes, when this view is ready, do that animation that we want. And when view is ready, we can just go on complete. When everything is calculated, view is laid out, and on pre-draw we can call this. And this is the end for the view property animator. I believe that we have some time left, so I can show another one. This is, again, another problem. And it looks something like this. Just a second. Okay, so our designs got crazy, and they want something like this to happen. So we have something like this. Oh, come on. I'll slow it down a little bit for you to see what's actually going on. So we have this, we click it here, and we have this view that just reveals and goes like from this some path, some colors running around, something. And then you go back, it just does the same thing backwards. And how could we do that? So this is the curve. On the newer APIs, we can actually easily animate some view while path, but we still have to support some older versions of the older APIs, which is a little bit tricky. And also we have that fade in after that initial reveal. And we could use view property animators, but they share the same interpolator, which is not good for us. So we could maybe use two value animators, one for the X and one for the Y coordinate. And yeah, it looks like we could do it. We subscribe to the values, and it looks like observable. So let's try it. If we wrap it in the observable, we can use a subject. And subject is like a proxy where we send our values when we get something from the listener. So we'll take our value animator, we'll create a subject, and we'll just wrap around the value animator. And it looks something like this. We take a value animator, create a here a subject, a listener where we just pass that value to the subject, and when it completes, we complete that subject. And our schedule function is just starts the value animator, enters the subject that we can subscribe to. And the animation looks something like this. We create both value animators for X and Y, and then we wrap it up in the observable animators. And the cool stuff is that we can use some combine latest or something similar from the observable to zip both of the values and update our view accordingly to the values. And when it's done, we just notify the presenter. Also, we can just schedule a reserved reverse animation for the end animation. And that's okay, that work. Also, we can just wrap it up in a completable if our presenter cares only about the end. And we can just, again, use our completable on subscribe. We get the value animator, we pass through that value action that is called when some value is passed from the value animator. And when it subscribes to, we just started, add a new listener when calls uncompleted on it. And as I said, it's important to clear our value animator here, because if our view gets removed and we just try to animate something on it, it could crash. And this is how our activator fragment looks like. We want to animate widget, we create value animator, so start value and value, set duration, and wrap it up. Pass it to the presenter, start it, we want to end it, and we update widgets here on the update widget function. And that will be it. If you have any questions, you fire up now, yeah.